Very good afternoon to all. Today we will be discussing about types of end closures. So we have already discussed about the unfired pressure vessel, what is a pressure vessel, what is called as a cylindrical shell, then what are the formulas for this, calculating the thickness for cylindrical shell, spherical shell. Now next part is end closures. So a spherical shell will be there. If it is not closed, it will act as just a pipe or both sides open. So it is closed. Now there are different shapes. So let us see types of end closure. So very first, what is the end closure? So end closure is used for closing the ends of the pressure vessel. Just I will give you one example here. These are the two different shells. I am showing you this welding joints also. So this is shell one, this is shell two, and they are already joined to each other. And now this is one shell. Now we have to close it so as it will act as a pressure vessel. So end closure means I will close it on this side. For example, like M is spherical. This we have discussed in one of the numerical. So like this. So this is nothing but called as the end closure. So there are different types of end closure, and depending upon the application, these are used. So very first, formed heads are used as end closures for cylindrical pressure vessels. Formed heads, they are made by using a plate is taken and by using the punch and die, the required shape is achieved and it is called as the forming operation. So formed heads are used as end closures. So whatever shape I have shown, this is nothing but the whatever this shape, or you can say this is the shape. These are nothing but the formed heads, or this is also called as domed headers also. So dome heads, there are two types of end closure. So formed heads is one category. So there are two types of enclosures, domed heads and conical heads. Domed heads, again there are three different types, hemispherical, semi-ellipsoidal and torispherical. So while the name only you take, it will give some significance. So hemispherical, half part of the sphere. Semi-ellipsoidal, so we have heard the name ellipse, and torispherical, this we will discuss what type of shape it is. Now we will be discussing what is the hemispherical, what are the salient features of this particular, and what is the formula for calculating the thickness of this hemispherical joint. And another is conical heads. Starting one by one, so there are three types, domed heads. So let us discuss, concentrate first on the hemispherical heads. Okay, I request you to give this note down the formulas which will be useful for solving the numerical. So just write it as one hemispherical head, draw the diagram, and then write down the formula. Okay, so hemispherical heads, these heads have minimum plate thickness, minimum weight, and consequently lowest material cost. So I will underline the words here, the features as per as this hemispherical is concerned. So they are minimum plate thickness, minimum, as plate thickness is minimum, weight is also minimum, and consequently the material cost is also lower. But however, the amount of forming required to produce the hemispherical is more, resulting in increased forming cost. So what is written here? What is mentioned here? The amount of forming required. See here. So forming, taking a flat plate of required size and making it a complete sphere or half part of sphere, you can say. So for the forming required is maximum. We will discuss the three types in comparative with other two, means semi ellipsoidal and torispherical. The forming required for this category, hemispherical, is more, and therefore the as far as the fabrication cost or forming cost is more. The thickness is given by, very important. So the thickness is given by, for this case I can say the thickness is given by T is equal to pi ri divided by twice sigma t eta minus 0.2 pi plus ca. One by one we will discuss. Pi, the pressure, internal pressure. Ri, it is the mentioned here. Ri is the inner radius of the cylindrical shell. Sigma t, the permissible stresses. If ultimate tensile stresses are given, we can calculate sigma t as SUT divided by factor of safety. Eta, eta is nothing but we have discussed, it is the weld joint efficiency. We have seen the weld joint efficiency depending upon which type of joint is used, and the radiograph, full radiograph, spot radiograph, or not radiograph, the weld joint efficiency varies. Okay, and the new term here is CA. CA stands for the corrosion allowance. So whatever thickness you will get, some corrosion allowance is separately added in the thickness in order to avoid the failure due to corrosion. Let us assume that you will get the answer as 7.5 for thickness. I will round up it as 8. And assume that corrosion allowance is 2 millimeters. So 8 plus 2, your thickness will become 10. The additional 2 millimeters thickness is provided in order to consider the corrosion allowance in account, depending upon the which fluid it is passing, or the cylinder is handling which type of fluid, gas. So, okay, and this is the diagram. If you refer to the diagram, this is the hemispherical head, the inner diameter DI, outer diameter DO, and here as hemisphere, simple is construction. So it's very simple, dimensions are there. T is the thickness, and RI stands for the inner radius of the cylindrical shell. RI stands for inner radius of cylindrical shell. Okay, so I will give you 1 minute, you heading, diagram and formula, so that we will proceed for the next type. Okay, so let us move further. This is about the hemispherical head. So minimum plate thickness, minimum weight, lowest material cost, but the fabrication or manufacturing cost is more, as maximum amount of forming is required as compared to other two types, and the thickness is given by the formula. Next is semi-ellipsoidal head. If you refer the figure, again you will come to know the shape here. The shape you can observe clearly, this is semi-ellipsoidal head. In a semi-ellipsoidal head, the ratio of major axis to minor axis is taken as 2:1. Now we all know the terminology for ellipse. So ratio of major axis to minor axis is taken as 2:1. Major to minor, 2:1. The thickness of the semi-ellipsoidal shell is given by T is equal to pi di divided by twice sigma t eta minus 0.2 pi plus CA. I will say here equation number 2. So if I compare equation 1 with equation 2, PI RI and PI DI. Okay, twice sigma t eta minus 0.2 pi twice sigma t eta minus 0.2 pi plus ca. So in the last expression here it is ri, and now in this case it is di. So if I compare equation number 1 and equation number 2, it can be easily concluded that it is observed that the thickness of semi elliptoidal head is more, almost twice, so ri and di, not exactly but approximately twice than the corresponding hemispherical head, and to the extent material cost is more. See now here, if I take hemispherical head, thickness is 10 mm. If I take semi elliptoidal head, approximately it is 19 to 20 millimeters, almost twice. So the material cost will be more. And how the thickness? It is based on the formula PIRI and PIDI. So if you compare the formula, then you will come to know the thickness is almost twice. And as the thickness is more, definitely the material cost is almost double. Here material cost is more. So this is the first comparison between hemispherical and semi-elliptoid. However, due to shallow dish shape, the forming cost is reduced. You see here the shape. It is shallow as compared to hemispherical. If you see the hemispherical, and now this, if you see the shape, then you can say that less forming is required for fabrication of this or preparation of this semi-ellipsoidal head. Therefore, forming cost is reduced. Okay. If you see the terminology, T is the thickness, DI inner diameter, DO outer diameter, and SF. SF is the straight portion, straight part, and SF is given by 3 times of thickness. So what is mentioned here? SF is nothing but 3 times of thickness or 20 mm, whichever is maximum. Very one, very important. Whichever is maximum. So this is about the semi-ellipsoidal head. Give the heading, draw the diagram, and write down the formula. Once again, I will repeat the semi-ellipsoidal head. The name only indicates ellipsoidal. So here the ratio of major axis to minor axis is taken as 2:1. The thickness is given by formula PIDI divided by twice sigma t eta minus 0.2 pi plus CA, where CA stands for the coronal allowance, DI the internal diameter, PI the internal pressure, sigma t the permissible stresses, eta weld joint efficiency, and CA corrosion allowance. If you compare the formula number 1 for hemispherical and formula number 2 for semi-ellipsoidal, then it can be concluded that it is observed that the thickness of semi-ellipsoidal head is more as compared to hemispherical. And how much more? Approximately twice. Therefore, material cost is more in this case. However, due to shallow dished shape, so if you compare this shape with hemispherical, forming required is less, and therefore forming cost is reduced. In the figure, you can observe the SF, straight portion, and it is given by 3 times of thickness or 20 mm, whichever is maximum. So this is about the semi-ellipsoidal head. Now friends, proceeding further to the third type, torispherical head. Torispherical heads are extensively used as end closures for horizontal pressure vessels such as tankers for water, milk, petrol, diesel, kerosene, etc. They are also used for small vertical pressure vessels. They are shaped by using 2 radius, crown radius L and knuckle radius RI. So these 2 terminologies we will discuss by taking help of figure also. So there are 2 radius, crown radius L and knuckle radius RI. Crown radius L is the radius of dish that constitute the major portion of the head. Major portion of the head. And knuckle radius RI is the corner radius joining the spherical crown and cylindrical shell. So this part you can call it as so crown radius. So here L, you can say L stands for the crown radius. It is the major portion. If you see, this is the major portion to crown. And RI, RI is the radius which is joining, corner radius which is joining the spherical crown with cylindrical shell. So this is the crown and it is joining to this part is cylindrical shell, the part of descent only. So this radius is nothing but RI. RI is the knuckle radius. So this is also called as knuckle. So I will knuckle radius. Okay. For spherical heads require less forming than semi-ellipsoidal. See now, this is third type. Again, less forming. So hemispherical, maximum forming. Second semi-ellipsoidal, somewhat lesser forming. This is third type. Again, lesser forming is required. The main drawback of this drawback is the local stress at two discontinuities, namely the junction between crown and head and the knuckle radius and the junction between knuckle radius and cylindrical shell. So what is the main drawback? I will tell you how it is manufactured. So the part is manufactured up to this. Here, this is manufactured up to this. Then the middle part and then the shell part. So what is mentioned here? Local stresses due to two discontinuity, just between crown and head. So if you see the radius, crown head and knuckle radius, and knuckle radius and cylindrical. So see, this is the crown and knuckle radius. So this joint is there. And this joint, so it is only one joint representing on two sides, and between the knuckle and the cylinder, so here it is joined. Two joints will be there. It is not possible to go in a single way. So here, due to this two times wielding, discontinuity will be there and stress, local stresses will be there due to this. And the localized stresses may lead to failure due to brittle fracture. So this localized stresses may lead to brittle fracture and there will be ultimate failure occurs due to this. This is about the torus spherical head. The thickness of the torus spherical head is given by 0.885 pi into L. L, what you will say L? L is nothing but the crown radius. So if you see here, L crown radius, PI internal pressure, sigma T, permissible stresses, eta weld joint efficiency, and CA, the corrosion allowance. And the knuckle radius RI is taken as 6% of crown radius. So in the numerical, if RI is not given, you will take 0.06 times of PL. RI will be taken as 0.06 times of PL. So this is about the torus spherical head. Once again, I will repeat. These are the extensively used heads. So there are two radius, crown radius L and knuckle radius RI. The crown is the major portion. So if you see, it is the radius of dish L and it is the major portion, main portion. It covers the maximum area. The knuckle is the corner radius and it requires the less forming as compared to semi-ellipsoidal and very, very less as compared to the first type, that is hemispherical heads. And the thickness is given by, there are some stress discontinuities due to the welding between the crown radius and knuckle radius and knuckle radius to cylindrical shell. So these two times welding, it will induce the, this may fail due to the brittle fracture due to these discontinuities in the weld. Now, the thickness of this torus spherical head is given by, it is formula. So give the heading, write down the formula and draw the diagram. So I will say this is formula number 3. 0.885 pi into L divided by sigma t eta minus 0.1 pi plus CA corrosion allowance. The knuckle radius RI is taken as 6% of the crown radius. Therefore, RI 0.06 into L. I will give you 1 minute, then we will proceed for the next. Okay, so let us move further. Conical heads. This is not come under dome head, so this is separate type. The shape only indicates conical head. The thickness of conical head is given by one formula is there. Give the heading, then write down the formula. T is equal to pi di divided by twice cos of alpha sigma t eta minus 0.6 pi plus corrosion allowance. So pi internal pressure, di inside diameter. Alpha is the half apex angle. This is some different term. Eta weld joint efficiency, ca corrosion allowance. So what is alpha? So alpha is here mentioned, half apex angle. So if you refer in the diagram, this angle is nothing but angle alpha. And the thickness is also given. So here, thickness is shown. So di internal diameter, do. And the half apex angle is usually 30 degree. The half apex angle is usually 30 degree. So give the heading. Draw the diagram, write down the formula. We will move for problem number one. I will give you 1 minute. Okay, so this is about conical heads. Let us discuss two different numericals. If you consider this chapter, numerical number 8. On this type, numerical number 1. We will take two numericals on this. Small numericals are there. So, a horizontal pressure vessel consists of a cylindrical shell of inside diameter 1650 millimeter. That is enclosed by a torus spherical head with a crown radius of 130. Operating pressure. So what is operating pressure? So here it is given 1.5 MPa, megapascal. So I will, but I will write here a complete word because we want to design pressure while calculating. All the formulas, it is design pressure only. Therefore, we have to convert this operating into design. MPa is nothing but Newton per mm square. The pressure vessel is fabricated from steel plates with a yield strength of 255 Newton per mm square. So I will say yes, YT is equal to 255 Newton per mm square. Eta is equal to the weld joint efficiency is given 0.8 and the corrosion allowance CA is equal to 2 millimeter. What is asked? The thickness of cylindrical shell and thickness of torus spherical end closure. Thickness of cylindrical shell and thickness of torus spherical end closure. So we will go slowly solving one by one point. So very first we will calculate the sigma t. So I will say here sigma t is equal to syt by fs. So I will say sigma t is equal to 255 fs is not given. So read, let us assume as so you mentioned there, huh? fs is assumed as 1.5, huh? Calculate sigma t newton per mm square. Yeah. 170 newton per mm square. Then I will proceed further. Then I will go for design pressure. These are the basic things that required to calculate before going for actual formula. So design pressure. So I will say here, whatever we are using in formula, it is nothing but design pressure. PI is equal to 1.05. Design pressure is 1.05 times operating pressure. So I will say PI is equal to 1.05 into 1.5. So it will be, you will get PI is equal to 1.5 newton per mm square. Okay. Now I will go for calculation of thickness of cylindrical shell and thickness of torus spherical head. So thickness of cylindrical shell by considering the allowance. Thickness of cylindrical shell. So now this formula will be common for whenever the thickness of cylindrical shell is asked, you will use this formula. Depending upon the end, torus spherical, hemispherical, or semi ellipsoidal, the formula will change. But this formula, PI DI divided by twice sigma T eta minus PI plus corrosion allowance. This is the formula by considering corrosion allowance. So I will say, put substituting all the values. 1.5715 into DI 1650 divided by twice sigma T 2 into 170 into wheel joint efficiency 0.8 minus PI 1.5715 plus corrosion allowance is given 2 mm. So you will get thickness in millimeters. Calculate the thickness. Tell me answer, thickness in millimeters. T is equal to 11.63. Okay, so I will say here 11.609 millimeter. I will call it as 12 millimeter. Okay. Here you can see the thickness of the cylindrical shell is 12 millimeter. Now the last part, the thickness of spherical head. So I will write the thickness of spherical head is given by. We are having the formula, so write down the formula for this. So T is equal to 0. We have discussed 885 times pi into L divided by sigma t eta minus 0.1 pi plus corrosion allowance. This formula we have discussed here. So same I have written. So now substitute the values. You will get the value of thickness t is equal to 0.885 into 1.575 into length. L is the crown radius divided by sigma t 170 into eta 0.8 minus 0.1 pi, so 0.1 into 1.575 and plus corrosion allowance will be there plus 2. So you will get thickness is equal to mm. Put the answer 15.339. Okay, I will say 34. Okay, so 15.339 or 34. I will call it as 16 millimeter. So thickness of spherical head, I will mention here. Thickness of spherical head t is equal to 15.399, that is 16 millimeters. 16 millimeters. Okay. Quite simple problem. We will discuss one new more numerical based on this. Numerical number 2 or next numerical in this chapter. So write down what is given. Just have a look towards the numerical and write down what is given. ओके सो लेट अस राइट डाउन व्हाट इज गिवन इन दिस. तो ए हॉरिजॉन्टल प्रेशर वेसल कौन सी टॉप सिलेंड्रिकल सेल एनक्लोज बाय हेमिस्फेरिकल एंड. सिलेंड्रिकल सेल हेमिस्फेरिकल एंड लास्ट न्यूमेरिकल वी हैव डिस्कस सिलेंड्रिकल सेल विथ टॉरिस्फेरिकल हेड. So now let us write down given. Horizontal pressure vessel. Okay, the internal diameter of the cylinder shell is 950 mm. So I will directly write down DI, the internal diameter is equal to 950 millimeters. The pressure vessel is fabricated from steel plates with yield strength of 255 newton per mm square. So here yes, YT is given 255 newton per mm square. The weld joint efficiency eta is given 0.85. It indicate that double welded butt joint with spot radiograph. The corrosion allowance is given CA is equal to 2 millimeters. The pressure vessel is subjected to operating pressure of 2 megapascals. So I will say here operating pressure. Megapascal. We have to calculate the thickness of cylindrical shell and hemispherical end closure. So just as in case of last, let us calculate one by one. So sigma t is equal to SYT by FS. FS is not given, I will assume. So again 255, same value as last case, divided by 1.5. So I will say sigma t is equal to 170 newton per mm square. Okay. So next I will calculate here the design pressure. The design pressure. So I will say PI is equal to 1.05 into operating pressure 1.05 into 2. So you will get PI is equal to 2.1 MPa. Very simple. So these are the two things that are required to calculate for proceeding the further numerical. These are the points required. Let us calculate the thickness of cylindrical shell and thickness of okay, so this we have calculated at the design requisite sigma t, then this we have calculated as the PI. So now we will calculate thickness of cylindrical shell. Cylindrical shell. So I will write down the formula first for this. So it is given by P is equal to PI DI divided by twice sigma t eta minus PI plus PA. Just substitute all the values. 2.1 इनटू डी आई 950 डिवाइडेड बाय 2 इनटू 170 इनटू 0.8 माइनस पी आई, तो माइनस हियर यू विल राइट 2.1 प्लस कोरोजन अलाउंस इज देयर 2 मिलीमीटर. सो सब्स्टिट्यूट ऑल द वैल्यूज एंड टेल मी द वैल्यू ऑफ थिकनेस इन मिलीमीटर्स.